Realme's meteoric rise in the country in a short span of time is definitely commendable. While most of the growth has happened on the backbone of smartphone sales, Realme as a company is trying to diversify like OnePlus and Xiaomi. And therefore, we got the Realme Buds, these ultra-affordable Realme Buds, earlier this year, where Realme could kick off the audio accessories product category. But guess what? We already have the Realme Buds 2. Now, the Realme Buds 2 are the second iteration of the Realme Buds series, and the price has been increased by 100 bucks. Although, are all the upgrades on the Realme Buds 2 worth the price increase? Well, I'm Ershad from Mr. Phone, and that's what we're gonna find out in our review of the newly launched Realme Buds 2. But before we move on, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it to get notified whenever Mr. Phone puts out an awesome new tech video. The Realme Buds 2's design is an evolution of the original Realme Buds. It's still all black, especially the cable and the housings themselves, plus the inline microphone. But you get these yellow accents can be seen in the internal portion of the ear tips, on the volume button indicators, plus on the adjustable strap. Now, black is a classy color, but adding a dash of yellow, you know, creates a lot of fun element to it. I quite like it. I quite like the design language. Now, as far as the rest of the design elements are concerned, you get a silver plated 3.5 mm jack, which is a straight jack. And apart from that, up until the Y split, the wire is protected by a braided jacket that gives it a touch of character plus a good feel and sturdiness as well. Now, Realme claims that it has completely eliminated tangling of these earphones, but that's not so, you know, true, because inside a pair of jeans pocket, it definitely does get tangled. However, the practical use of it, for example, the fact that on a OnePlus Bullets Wireless 2, you can play and pause music, actually adds to the practical use of it. That doesn't happen here because I don't think you'll be dangling them through your, you know, head, so it's just weird. But otherwise, I think that this is a nice design touch and element. It ensures that these don't, like, you know, go and fray outside like this. Now, one of the things I really like about the design is the fact that the Realme Buds 2 have a brushed metal finish. Obviously, it's not made of metal, it's made of plastic, because in this pressing, you're not going to get metal. Having said that, I really like this finish. It gives it a premium touch overall. And the rear is also sloping where it attaches at the magnet, so that looks really good. It's not a chunky block of plastic. This is pretty useful because it helps in keeping them held together. So yeah, for the sticker price of ₹599, these are very well built in my opinion. Now, coming to the sound quality of these earphones, Realme doesn't mince any words. The marketing speak says, feel the real bass. And you know what? Just to do that, I connected these earphones to my Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, of course, with earphone dongle, because this one doesn't have a headphone jack. But I did that and I realized that, this one definitely has dollops of bass. I tested out Mirza by Nuclear, which is one of my favorite songs to test the bass, and the mid bass is extremely punchy and it doesn't bleed into the other frequencies as well. That's pretty good. While it doesn't bleed into the other frequencies, I felt that it definitely kills the details and the dynamics in the song. In a song like AWOL Nation by Sale, the mids were completely subdued and that wasn't really cool. And therefore, the bass frequencies tend to overpower the other frequencies on more occasions than one. Honestly though, as far as the lack of details and dynamics are concerned, I wasn't expecting much from a pair of ₹600 earphones. Now, one of the things I didn't like particularly about the earphones' sound signature is the fact that the highs are slightly rolled off. This is particularly evident in the cymbal scratching that underlines the entire song, or called Past Ain't Past by Chris Forsythe, which is an excellent metal song, but you know, you don't get the feel because the cymbal scratching sound doesn't sound as good. So don't go expecting any nuances in the sound signature and you're good to go. Also, don't go expecting any great soundstage, because these are a pair of earphones that don't cost more than a meal for two at McDonald's. So, you know, keep your expectations in check. What I do like about the sound signature, and I have to mention this, is the fact that the imaging is pretty decent. I mean, for a pair of ₹600 earphones, the sounds weren't muddy. The instrumentation was pretty good, actually. I could clearly distinguish between the instruments' sounds, and that is absolutely exceptional for a pair of earphones that cost only this much. And to top it all off, the stereo separation is pretty good too, so no complaints there. So overall, you might think that I'm disappointed with the sound signature of the Realme Buds 2.0, but that's not really the case. I know and understand what Realme has done with the tuning of the sound signature. It is targeted at a demographic that's generally listening to a lot of streaming music and to a demographic that listens to a lot of Raftaar and DJ Snake and Nuclear. So it is the Gen Z that's listening to a lot of bass heavy thumping sounds. I might not be a fan of extra bass sound, but I know that a lot of kids are, and it does this well for this price. So I'm pretty sure that you will like the sound signature as well if you are into bass. And one thing's for sure, it sounds better than the OG Realme Buds. Okay, so talking about the microphone quality, I found them to be pretty good, no problem at all. The call quality was good and I didn't have to pull it towards my mouth to actually sound better. And you know, even the caller on the other end sounded good as well. Now, one good thing about the inline microphone and remote is the fact that you can also invoke your voice assistant of choice. So when I connected it to my Galaxy Note 10 Plus, it gave me the option to pick between Google Assistant and Bixby. That's pretty useful and these are pretty cheap. So if they can do that, that's actually pretty good. So that was my entire review. We're at the end of the review. And like I said, these are tailor-made for bass heads. So if you identify as one, go pick these up. And even if you listen to a few bass heavy tracks once in a while, you should pick these up because the asking price is not that much and you can use one as secondary anyway. But if you want something more audiophile grade, I would suggest picking up something like the V-Monk 2, which is better of course. But in this price range, to expect great soundstage and imaging and clarity and dynamics and all of those jazz that are important for an audiophile, you can't do that. I mean, that'd be asking for too much. This does one thing and does that one thing well. I think that's what Realme is going for here as well. Now, if you own the original Realme Buds, I think that upgrading to the Realme Buds 2 actually does make sense. And what is more interesting is the fact that we already have a video of best earphones under ₹500, and the Realme Buds were actually adjudged as the best one, and you've got the Realme Buds 2, which actually one-ups that. So definitely kudos Realme, good job, well done. So that's it from me. That was my review of the Realme Buds 2.0. I'm Ershad from Mr. Phone. See you in the next one. Goodbye and Godspeed, my friends.